Sampling. Simple, convenience, systematic, cluster, and stratified. To find things out about a population of interest, it is common practice to take a sample. A sample is a selection of objects or observations taken from the population of interest. For example, a population might be all apples in an orchard at a given time. We wish to know how big the apples are. We can't measure all of them, so we take a sample of some of them and measure them. The method chosen for taking the sample depends on the nature of the population and the resources available in terms of time and money. The ideal is for each object in the population to be equally likely to be chosen as part of the sample. This is called an unbiased sample. It is also desirable for the sample to be representative of the population. If the population of apples were 2/3 red and 1/3 green, the sample should be similarly split. Note that no matter what we do, there will always be sampling error or variation due to sampling, as we are looking at a part of the population, not the whole population. The video on variation covers these concepts more thoroughly. This video presents five methods of sampling: simple random sampling, convenience sampling, systematic sampling, cluster sampling, and stratified sampling. For each method, we will outline the process and the advantages and disadvantages. Simple random sample. Simple random sampling is theoretically the ideal method of sampling. You list each member of the population and use random numbers to decide which objects are in the sample. Each object is equally likely to be selected. This produces an unbiased sample, which we hope is representative. However, it can be difficult and expensive to take a simple random sample when dealing with people. Simple random sampling is more practical when a population is geographically concentrated and when a good sampling frame exists. A sampling frame is a list of all the people or objects in the population of interest. Simple random sampling can be more easily implemented for natural and manufacturing populations. Convenience sample. Convenience sampling is just that, convenient. You ask people nearby or people who walk past at a shopping mall. Or you take the next 20 objects off the production line. You do what is easy or convenient. Convenience samples are often biased in some way, but for a quick and cheap poll, it may not really matter. Convenience samples can also have self-selection bias when people choose to participate because they have an interest in the issue in question. Systematic sampling. With systematic sampling, you choose a starting point at random and then systematically take objects at a certain number apart. For example, if there are 1,000 in the population and you want a sample of 50, you would take every 20th object. Systematic samples are easier to administer than simple random samples and are usually a good approximation of a random sample. However, if there is a pattern in the population, certain types of objects could be chosen more or less often than others. Cluster sampling. In cluster sampling, the population is divided into clusters which are then chosen at random. For example, departments of a business can be clusters, or suburbs within a city. Within each cluster, all of the objects are included in the sample. Cluster sampling can be more convenient and practical than simple random sampling. However, if the clusters are different from each other with regard to the elements we are measuring, it can lead to bias or non-representativeness. Stratified sampling. Stratified sampling seems like cluster sampling, but the strata, or groups, are chosen specifically to represent different characteristics within the population, such as ethnicity, location, age, or occupation. Within each group, a random sample is taken, sometimes in proportion to the size of the group. Stratified sampling can lead to a very good random representative sample. However, it can be complex to administer, and a sampling frame with considerable information about the population is required. There are other sampling methods. The five explained here give an idea of the advantages and disadvantages of various methods. You should attempt to use the sampling method that produces the best result for the resources you have available. If your sample has known bias, this should be taken into account in analysis and reporting.